In this brief session, I'm going to explain the process on how to create labels. The process is actually simpler than one thinks, or they are used to probably tinkering with it. But basically, all you have to have is Microsoft Word, and then the best is to use an Excel file. The Excel file could be a list of names. On the first row can be different labels, for example, the customer number, the company, the first name, last name, telephone, state address, city, zip, and so on. You could have here any other new fields as well. So this list, as you can see, you can create it by either extracting it from an existing system, or you can simply type those addresses and keep those in a list somehow, somewhere, by simply typing them one after the other. So then the next step here is, I'm going to close this. You don't need the Excel file open when you do this. And we need to go to Microsoft Word. Under Word, we need to click on Mailings tab here. So we click on actually a mail merge option here. And then we go under step-by-step wizard. I usually recommend the step-by-step wizard because it takes you step by step, as it says, in order to generate those labels. So we click here, and then we tell the system that we are going to create labels. Then click on next to start the document. Then the next here is telling us that we are going to use the current document layout, or you can use an existing document if you want, but in this case it's going to be labels just populated with the basic names and addresses. If you wanted something where it says labels for with other information, then you can simply type it here on the left hand side. Then the next option here is to choose label options. We need to tell the system what kind of labels are we using for this mail merge. Then here under label vendors, unless you have Microsoft, you need to change it to something else. And usually the most common one is the Avery US letter. Under Avery US letter, notice there are a lot of different ones. And usually when you go to the store and buy those, you'll have the number directly on the label. So it will tell you on the box of labels as to which number it is, which product number. So one of the common ones that we use is the Avery 5160, which tells me it's 1 inch in height and then 2.63 inches. So we click OK here. The next step here in the bottom, notice it says go to the select the recipients. So we click on select recipients, and then you can use an existing list. You can use the contacts from Outlook, or you can type a new list if you want it as well. But like I said earlier, it's easier to just type the list first in Excel and then you just utilize that list. So we go here under use an existing list, and then we go and find it and locate it. Click on browse, and then we are going to go here under week 3. And this is the customer list for mail merge. Now in here, there are two tabs or two sheets in this spreadsheet. Now, when I had this earlier, it was the first one. So basically, I'm not going to open it again, but it's going to be one of the first ones. Usually when you open Excel, it's going to have 2 to 3 tabs that it starts with. So we'll pick the first one, and these are all the names. You could filter those names if you wanted, but for now, we're going to leave everything alone for the sake of simplicity. Then we are going to go, and here on the first one, we are going to click on Insert Merge Field. So we go here to the first label, and then we click on Merge Insert Merge Field, and we say Insert First Name, a space, Insert Last Name, hit Enter, then Insert Street Address, hit Enter again. And then we are going to insert the city, comma, state, and then the zip. Now here is where pretty much everybody has problems, because the labels don't populate through all the fields. So the next thing what you need to do here is we click on Arrange Labels, and then the next thing what you have to do here is click on Update All Labels. So before you go and preview them, you want to update the same information that you see here to all of the labels all over in that same sheet. So the computer will do this automatically for you, and this is just for the labels. You click on Update All Labels, and notice it's a whole bunch of stuff in there. Then we click on Preview Your Labels, and notice the information is posted. If for some reason we want to change something here, we could go back to the previous step where the code stuff is, highlight it, let's say the first and last name, we want to make it bold. Click on bold there. If you want to put the word to, we could do that right in front of it. But then remember to update all labels again, and that will populate all the labels. Then preview your labels, and then complete the merge. You can preview them, how it's going to look page by page by page. But basically, the last step, what you want to do is complete the mail merge. You complete it, you could print it, or you can click on Edit Individual Labels. If we click on Edit Individual Labels, click on OK, this is the final product. So the final product here, basically, it's the whole merged results. This you shouldn't have to tinker with it. If something is not correct, it is recommended that you go back to your Excel file. I'm not going to save the results here. You go to your Excel file, you change whatever you need to change, and then you come here to the previous step, which, by the way, you can save this form, and you can save it particularly with the codes at this stage. And anytime you run it in the future, it will actually pull from the same list of addresses and list of information. You just have to keep the same file, the data file, and the form. This is referred to as the form file, in the same folder. It's basically the same folder, or linked it, the same structure that it was to start with. And then once you change something, you just go back to preview the labels and complete the merge all over again.